These are what I am calling simple gauges, uncomplicated but powerful tools with few or no moving parts that define precision. There is little or no room for misinterpretation with these tried and true standards. Every machinist grows to appreciate the place that these tools hold in the shop. Conclusive, trustworthy, certified accuracy. These gauges, in their most basic and powerful form, can be the fastest way to tell whether a part is good or bad. Good or bad, pass or fail, go or no go. Let's start here. These are pin gauges, also known as plug gauges, or even go, no-go pins. If we want to know what size a hole is, we test fit pins until we find a pin that fits, that is next to a pin that doesn't fit. We now know for certain that our actual hole size is somewhere between these two pin diameters. Now that's pretty quick. But if we just want to quickly find out if a feature is good or not within spec, we can pull pins at both the low end and the high end of our tolerance and load them into a go, no-go handle. If the go pin fits and the no-go pin does not fit, then we know that we have a good part. Nothing is faster, pass or fail, go or no-go. Some pin handles make use of actual collets, but they're only good for a few pin sizes. These pin handles are actual pin vices with an enormous range, kind of like little chucks. We can see how the three jaws are held parallel to the pin as the collets are closed. This one handle can accommodate any pin in this whole set. The same is true for this handle and set, and this one. Now, this might sound like a random fact, but as many as 1 in 10 men are colorblind. And this matters when looking at gauge pin handles, because while many of us see the red and green color markings on our go, no-go pin holders, a good number of operators just see this. Find a handle like this one that makes use of an identification groove, as well as colored end caps on top of go, no-go markings. This style of handle also makes a terrific pin vise for holding deburr tools and countersinks. This essential machinist tool looks an awful lot like gauge pins, and they're very similar, but they serve a very different purpose. These are thread measuring wires. These pins or wires are precision ground and come in sets of three. We use them along with a regular set of micrometers to measure the pitch diameters of outside threads. This is a pretty clever feat. We are told which pins to use based on which intrametric thread we're trying to measure. And it's all in this little manual that comes with the thread measuring wires. We follow the instructions, measuring on the outside of the three wires and subtracting the listed constant value. And we have our machine thread pitch diameter that we can compare to the nominal pitch value that we might find in our machinery's handbook or elsewhere. No heavy math, no trigonometry, simple. Now, if you are cutting threads all day long on a lathe, you need to be looking at a nice set of pitch micrometers. But for the price and simplicity of a set of thread measuring wires, they belong in every machinist's box. These are threaded ring gauges, and we can use them to check and see if our outside diameter threads are within tolerance. These gauges have been precision ground at the top and bottom of our thread tolerances to work as go and no-go gauges. If the go threads on and the no-go does not, then we know that our specific thread pitch is correct. We will still want to check our thread major diameter with a set of calipers or micrometers. These threaded ring gauges are checking our pitch and our pitch diameter all in one shot. Go, no-go gauges are fast and reliable. For threaded holes, we can use threaded plug gauges to make sure that all of our internal threaded features are correct. Again, we have a precision ground go side, which should thread in nicely, and a precision ground no-go side, which should not thread in. These gauges are checking our thread pitch, our thread lead, and our pitch diameter all at one time. For a more complete ID thread inspection, we're going to want to check our thread minor diameter as well. That was created with our tap drill, and we can check that using regular gauge pins. Of the hundreds of different inspection tools available to us, gauge blocks are special. Now, they don't appear to do much. They just sit there with no electronics, no gears, no moving parts at all. But this isn't a fault, it's their genius. Designed to be stacked one on top of another with high reliability and precision, they're the final say in accuracy when used to measure our parts or calibrate other inspection tools. Pick a number, any number, and we can create a stack of gauge blocks to that height in increments of just 1 micron for our metric sets or 1/10 of a thou for our inch sets. Placed on a granite surface plate, our gauge blocks can be used as a reference to measure the height of a part or feature with incredible precision. Combined with a drop gauge, our gauge blocks can provide the absolute reference values that we need. Now, we will use gauge blocks along with a little trigonometry to produce perfect angles using sine bars or sine plates. Now, we don't just stack our blocks together. We actually ring them together, like wringing our hands. This creates a strong bond that holds them firmly in place. Now, this is an amazing property of physics that is worth looking up sometime. With the right accessories, they can be used to create precision gauges for inside diameters, ID features as well, saving us the cost and lead times of custom ring gauges for every job. Gauge blocks provide that second opinion, the final verdict, when it comes time to verify all of our other adjustable measurement tools. For easily setting up or inspecting precision angles, we can use angle blocks, one at a time, or we can stack them to create any angle we'd like. I'll often use them in a vise, avoiding the hassle needed to create angled fixturing for quick jobs. And remember, these can be stacked or rotated to create the angles that we need. In the world of physics, a simple machine is a basic mechanical device that changes the direction or magnitude of a force. Like a lever, wheel and axle, pulley, inclined plane, wedge, or screw. Simple, yes, with few or no moving parts, but absolutely revolutionary, just like our simple gauges. These gauges quite literally set the standard for all of our other inspection tools. When we need clarity on a measurement, it is hard to argue with these simple gauges.